If you don't stand for something, you will fall for anything.
السلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Let me tell you why I am here. 8 years ago, somebody gave me Muazzam's book, Enemy Combatant. I read this book. After reading this book, I felt very, very bad that this brother lived in Birmingham. I knew him as well at that time, not so well. And the difficulties that this man had gone through, and I did nothing. I did nothing. And that was what prompted me to come here today. That a person is going through oppression and we do not assist that person. A man who asked questions. Who was Muazzam asking these questions? On behalf of who? Renditions, illegal imprisonments, torture. On the behalf of who? On behalf of the Muslim community. And we at times feel scared, threatened, and therefore we don't raise our voices. A hadith, a narration of the Prophet, peace be upon him, comes to my mind. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said that no believer should belittle himself. And the companions asked, O Messenger of Allah, how does a person belittle himself? And he said, the way a person belittles himself is that he sees an injustice and he does not speak up. He sees a wrong and he says nothing. On the day of judgment, Allah will ask him, you saw this injustice, why didn't you say anything? And he'll say, oh Allah, I was scared of the people. I was scared, so I remained quiet. You know, the Prophet, peace be upon him, taught this ummah, the believers, something. He taught it for a reason. He said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-jubni. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from being cowardice. We are not people who are cowardice. You have a man called Nelson Mandela, spends 27 years in prison, comes out and then forwards the cause, and he's a hero. And you have Muazzam Beg, spends 3 years in solitary confinement in Guantanamo Bay, and he comes and he forwards his mission. And he's regarded as a terrorist. Why? Because there's a climate being created, and that climate is this, that you can vilify, demonize the Muslims, call them a terrorist, and if there's smoke, there must be fire. And even, and we thank, you know, all the non-Muslim community who has come out, that you are ready to fight a cause. You are ready to fight a cause that many Muslims are too scared to fight. So we know Muazzam, and as far as I know Muazzam, I've always found him to be an intelligent, balanced brother. I was at a talk recently which he gave in Batley, where he said, he spoke about Syria, and even and the police were there as well, and he spoke about extreme groups in Syria. And he said, we know there are extreme groups. But the truth is, in reality, we know why Muazzam has been locked up. Difficult questions. You don't ask the establishment difficult questions. You don't ask the establishment. Let's move away from this belief that this is a just world. If the world was just, then Snowden would have been a hero. He would have been a hero. You know, he went against his own country to expose his own country. But the world isn't a just place. The strong will often believe that they can abuse the weak. But alhamdulillah, or praise be to Allah, it is our responsibility. It's our responsibility to speak the truth. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Afdhulul jihad kalimatu haqqin inda sultanin ja'ir." The greatest form of jihad, the greatest form of jihad to strive is to speak the truth. When you see the authorities doing something unjust. So nobody here has come to stand in the way of the law, but the law must be just for everybody. It must not discriminate and abuse minorities. So we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala release our brother Mu'azzam quickly, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to see this through. That is very important. The reason that we are here is that we know that Mu'azzam asks very difficult questions, and we want to make sure that he gets a fair trial. And therefore, the struggle has just started. It's just started. We want to see it to the end. And if we see any injustices, then it's a responsibility for us to speak. As Martin Luther King once said, he said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give our brother Mu'azzam, give him steadfastness.
Amen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the courage to assist him, in assist anybody who's fighting for a just cause. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Thank you very much.